This Holy Week, as people turn to their congregations perhaps more than at any other time of year, I wanted to take a moment to remind you of the hope of Easter. I know that the past year has been a dark and difficult one. COVID-19 has disrupted our lives more than we could have imagined. Racial tensions are heightened across our country. There's even economic uncertainty. Even in our churches, we've been hearing more and more stories of darkness, of division, of difficulty. Councils have struggled to figure out whether to open for worship or to stay shut, to require masks or not, to find ways to stay connected as a church community while also protecting members and the broader community during this time of pandemic. Pastors, too, have told me that they have been carrying an extra weight during this year of pandemic. Several feel on the edge of their calling. Even those that have functioned well during the heroic stage of COVID are starting to feel quite disillusioned. They're wondering, is all of this still worth it? Am I still called to ministry? Please know that you're not alone. We're struggling in this time of darkness together. And my prayer is that we will have the fortitude for the journey and we will find ways to support each other through it. Just as the darkness of Good Friday is followed by the light and joy of Easter morning, so too this time of darkness will pass and God's light will be able to shine. My prayer is that we will have the grace for each other as we await the light. Councils, your pastor is human. He or she is not the litmus test for your church's success or failure. They're not a ministry machine with an on and off switch. And if they have families, the stress of this COVID year is yet taking its toll on their spouses and their children. Is it possible to bless your pastor right now? Can you relieve them of some of the duties? Can you suggest an extra week of pulpit supply each month this spring? Or find another way to encourage a time of renewal? Pastors, your council members are also human. They reveal the image of God in their wisdom, compassion, and strength. They reveal Christ's transforming presence with them and their love for the church, for one another, and for you. They also reveal the ongoing struggle with sin in their blind spots, their impatience, and their stubbornness. They, like you, are human. Is it possible for you to bless your council members right now? Can you pray with them and for them? And as you look for opportunities to bless and support each other, I encourage you to be creative in thinking of practical ways to encourage one another so that we may all abide in Christ, as it says in John 15, rest in him, as it says in Matthew 11. And as John 17 says, be brought to complete unity so that the world will know that we serve a risen Savior. Please also know that the ministries of the CRCNA are here to help you, whether it is video sermons that you can use to give your pastor a week off, toolkits to help you, to have challenging conversations, or any number of things in between. Please don't hesitate to reach out and let us know what you're struggling with or how we can assist you. 2020 was not an easy year. 2021 remains challenging. But as the body of Christ, we put our faith in Christ, knowing that the light will overcome darkness. May your Easter be especially meaningful in this year as you reflect on that amazing promise. For he has risen. He has risen indeed. Hallelujah.